National Security Advisor Eduardo Año slams China over the increasing presence of Chinese ships in the West Philippine Sea. Let's hear more from Bianca Dava.
In its maritime patrols on Saturday, the Philippine Coast Guard monitored over 135 Chinese maritime militia vessels scattered in the area of Julian Felipe Reef, which is located 175 nautical miles west of Bataraza Town in Palawan. The PCG's BRP Sindangan issued radio challenges to the Chinese ships but did not receive any response.
You are sailing within Philippine Exclusive Economic Zone and Kalayaan Island Group. Your refusal to respond will be reported and will be dealt with accordingly. Over.
During its five-day rotation and resupply mission to the Kalayaan Island Group, the PCG first visited Pag-asa Island on Thursday. The 37-hectare Pag-asa is the largest Philippine-occupied island in the West Philippine Sea. Although it lies beyond the Philippines' exclusive economic zone, Pag-asa is the only Philippine-occupied island in Kalayaan with a civilian population. The following day, the PCG inaugurated its new Coast Guard station on the island. A China Coast Guard vessel and 19 Chinese maritime militia vessels were spotted near Pag-asa. From the island, the PCG's BRP Cabra proceeded to Likas Island or West York Island, also known as the Giant Turtle Sanctuary of the Kalayaan Island Group. An ABS-CBN News team was among the journalists on board BRP Cabra. From the ship, rotating troops and supplies were transferred to inflatable boats going to the island. 5 hours from Likas is the island of Patag or Flat Island. One of those manning the feature for over a month now is Coast Guard apprentice seaman Arnel Almazan. He said he is happy to be able to come home to his family for Christmas.
Masaya po kasi nakapag-serve ako sa ating bansa, sa babantay sa ating teritoryo. Pauwi na, makakapay nga.
The last feature BRP Cabra went to is Lawak Island, Kalayaan's bird sanctuary. This is Coast Guard Petty Officer 3rd Class Fritz Tautawan's first time to be assigned to Lawak.
Ginagawa namin to hindi lang para sa amin, sa pamilya namin, kundi para sa lahat, para sa bayan.
Due to rough weather, it took the PCG until past sunset to transfer rotating personnel and fresh provisions to the island. National Security Advisor Eduardo Año said China's actions in the West Philippine Sea are illegal and a form of bullying.
They do not adhere to the international order, sa rule of law. Kaya yung sinasabi niya na gray zone tactics, actually hindi na yung gray zone. It's pure bullying and it's pure illegal. So hindi na yung tinatawag na gray zone. And it's not acceptable in the international order.
The official believes Manila should counter Beijing's information operation by being transparent about what is truly happening in the West Philippine Sea. Año added, aside from Pag-asa Island, improvements are also underway in other Philippine-occupied features in the Kalayaan Island Group to further strengthen the country's position in the West Philippine Sea. Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN News, Kalayaan, West Philippine Sea.
Well, China once again defending its presence in the West Philippine Sea. Beijing claims it is reasonable and legal for its fishing boats to operate in Julian Felipe Reef. A Philippine lawmaker says government must review how intelligence funds are being used in the wake of the Marawi blast. For the Nao del Sur representative Zia Alonto Adyong, there is no other way to look at the attack but a lapse in security.
This is a perfect time for the country to really revisit what are the things that are being done by using these intelligence funds. Because ultimately, if this is going to happen again, it might really push us really to put stringent measures and to look into really what is being done and how our security sector utilizes the intelligence funds. This is the first time in Lano del Sur, no, apart from the things that we saw, the encounters and the Marawi siege. This is the first time that we experienced that an IED exploded, no, inside a facility, a public facility, which worries me because the technology and the know-how is transferable.
Adyong adds the blast also brings to the forefront the neglect in the rehabilitation of Marawi City.
By delaying the Marawi rehabilitation, it actually paves a fertile ground for violent extremism to grow. That's why our position really is to prioritize Marawi rehabilitation because it is well connected with our national security concerns.
Vice President Sara Duterte urges President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. to review a government deal with communist rebels that would pave the way for the resumption of peace talks. Duterte called that deal an agreement with the devil, saying rebels are not sincere in talking peace. She also urged President Marcos to review his amnesty proclamations.
Sana po ay isalang-alang natin ang ating mga komunidad na naging pugad ng mga terorista sa mahabang panahon na ngayon ay lumalaban na at tumutulong sa pamahalaan. Mr. President, we can negotiate for peace and reconciliation and pursue meaningful development efforts in the Philippines without capitulating to the enemies.
The small plane that went missing in Isabela last week has been found. The Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines said it was spotted on the ground during an aerial search this morning. The plane, which was carrying a pilot and a lone passenger, went missing last Thursday, shortly after taking off from Kawayan Airport. A Philippine lawmaker wants the re-imposition of the death penalty, particularly on foreigners convicted of drug charges in the country. Congressman Robert Ace Barbers made that statement after two Filipinos in China were recently executed on drug-related charges. He believes his push to revive capital punishment will now get more support from lawmakers.
They come to Philippine shores, sell all their shabu here because they probably see that we're too soft in our penalties. They probably feel that Philippines is one country that they can continue their illegal and illicit trade. Hindi malayo na medyo gumanda-ganda yung numbers of people voting in favor of this bill. And hopefully they realize that we're not doing this because we're barbarians. We're doing this because there must be some way for our Philippine laws to be a deterrent. I always believe that when we have this kind of penalty, it will send a strong signal and it will deter the perpetrators of these crimes.
The National Telecommunications Commission urged to suspend the operations of Sunshine Media Network International, or SMNI. PBA Party List Representative Margarita Ignacia Nograles filed that resolution, accusing SMNI of violating the terms of its congressional franchise. She says it is the duty of the NTC to stop SMNI from spreading false information. The resolution also cited a claim by SMNI anchor Jeffrey Celis. House Speaker Martin Romualdez spent 1.8 billion pesos for his travels. Celis later admitted his statement was erroneous. A House panel is also investigating the network for its alleged attempts to spread misinformation.